And I'm Felipe Matzenbacher.
Felipe and I, we met in film school about 10 years ago, I think. And we immediately felt a strong connection because both of us, we were actors before studying film and before becoming directors. So we had a big interest in the acting part in our films. And then we started working together and I think we created this way of working that is very collaborative. So we try to do everything together, from the writing process to the directing. We try as much as possible not to split roles and do everything together.
Yeah, and I think since the beginning we start like collaborating with script during the film school, script or with each other. And then when we graduated, we found our own production company. And then we start to work together more and more.
Yeah, Hard Paint started... the very original idea, I think, comes from a short film from that we shot in 2012, we released in 2013, that Felipe directed, called Empty Room. And that short film is about a guy called Pedro that doesn't leave his apartment. He's very reclusive, and the only person he has in the world is his sister Luisa, and she's about to move out, and at the end of the film she moves out and he's there completely alone. He bursts into tears and the short film ends. So that was like the original plot when we did that film. Actually, in the short film I played Pedro. And it's a very different character, even though they have these similarities, these social inabilities. But it didn't have the webcam or all these other aspects of the character. So we really enjoyed working with this character and with this idea of departures, of someone dealing with imminent departures. And so we decided to explore that more into a feature film. And then we start to develop and create the story of Hard Paint. Bruno is a stage actor from Porto Alegre, and we saw him in a play, and we were really taken by his performance, and we knew that one day we wanted to work with him. And when we were writing the script, we came up with the character of Leo, and we immediately thought of him because we thought he had this energy of being this solar person that walks into the room and already his presence takes control of the environment. And we thought the character was like that. So he was our first and only choice for that role. But for Pedro, it was a bit harder. We looked for a while for an actor from Porto Alegre. For us, was important since the film speaks a lot about the city, that the actor was from there. But we couldn't find anyone as we had envisioned the character. We wanted someone with a fragile appearance, but with this aggressiveness inside. And one day we were in a party and we noticed the DJ playing there. And the DJ was Chico. And then we thought he was much as we had imagined. You know, he was there with his long dark hair and very skinny, almost like this androgynous look. And you could see in his eyes that he had this intensity that we wanted the character to have. And then we went back home, we rewrote the script thinking of him as Pedro, and we enjoyed the result. So we sent him a message, we sent him the script for him to read. And we set up a coffee with Chico, and then we explained everything we wanted to do and what we wanted to talk about with the film. And he was really excited about doing it, but he said, look, I have never acted before in my life. So we agreed on doing this 7-month rehearse process with him and with Bruno, that little by little we were understanding these characters and finding how we would play them on camera, you know. So it was a very beautiful process, and they were never concerned on the sex scenes or anything. We're always very honest with our cast. This is something very important for us. So right at the beginning, on first time we meet them, we already say very frankly what we plan on doing and how much we plan on showing and why we want to show it that that way. And both of them, they were very comfortable with that. So it was one of the easiest parts of the process, I would say, actually.
Yeah, I think during the process of rehearsals, we start little by little, like give them like connections with the characters and tools of acting, especially Chico, because he never acted before. So, and little by little, we start to make some exercise to them to know their bodies, to know the bodies of each other, and to connect with the scenes. So it was very easy, I think, the whole shooting of the sex scenes.
It's always hard to say because acting is a very unpredictable career, but I think they started off with very strong first roles. I mean, both of them they won acting prizes at the Rio International Film Festival, which is like Brazil's biggest film festival, so that's a lot. And Chico now he wants to be an actor, so he enrolled in acting courses, and Bruno graduated in theater school, so I think that they have, I hope, a bright future coming ahead. So.
Yeah, I think we like the idea of working with this contrast between the material life of Pedro, which is very hard and gray and more violent, I think also, and in his webcam life, when he performs as Neon Boy, he become more colorful and like with the color more present. So I think it comes from this idea, and also the idea of working with the neon colors, almost like a symbol to queerness also.
Yeah, I think like the neon paint comes in the film as like this performatic thing that immediately detaches you from this gray heteronormative crowd, and that's something that I think Pedro especially he empowers himself with once he goes in the webcam, you know, and part of his journey is being able that even outside the webcam, his material life, he can bring this neon color, this neon paint on himself, like without the need of the actual paint, you know, almost like out of magic.
Yeah, I think during the process of writing, Brazil was becoming more and more conservative, and I think that crossed us during the writing, and it took us, and we feel the need of putting that. Pedro had to be in that conservative society, very judgmental, and so of course, for a person, especially to an LGBT person living that kind of society, he feel very judged and observed. So
I think we've done more things together actually. We've done a few other shorts before, and I wouldn't be able to count now, but I think maybe this would be the sixth or the seventh time we direct together, writing, so like even
yeah.
more. But for us, pretty easy, I think, to work together. We share similar references and especially similar interests in filmmaking, and we really enjoy doing collaborative process. We come from stage originally. We were actors before being directors, and because of that, I think we try to bring closer our film process to the stage process. That usually you have like a longer time of development, and it is more like a group thing that you discuss with people, you experiment, and sometimes filmmaking, because of course it's more expensive and there's some specific issues to it. It tends to be a very vertical and or is and hierarchical process.
And quick also.
Yeah, and very fast, like the way we do it. So we try to break that, and we try to have a longer process where we can talk more, discuss more among the two of us, and later on with the rest of the crew and the cast. And so we actually work pretty well with
Yeah.
that, so.
We love this idea of making movies almost like handmade, you know, like very step by step and working together and experimenting things from the very beginning to the end. That's a very interesting question, actually. I think Brazil is a very mixed country in general, but at the same time, it's very like the power of the country is very focused on only one main part of society, the white, straight, rich, like with European heritage. So it's very like many people of the country doesn't have access to a space of power, I think, place of power. So I think what happens with Pedro in the movie is that he is like in his own shell, because like the only place that he habitates is his apartment, and the connection with his sister, which she works as a journalist, so she's like in a position of power somehow. Even she's not like a powerful woman in the part of the news, like she has this position that but then he starts little by little going outside, and then he can meet different people in a more mixed crowd, I think. So and also that and that's something that's very I think related to freedom also. Because once he is becoming part of this more mixed crowd, he starts to empower himself also. Then he can understand how important it is to have this mixed people like together and like supporting each other. Because like once we live in a very conservative society, it's very important to all these groups of social groups becoming stronger and caring about each other, I think.
Yeah, I think like Pedro in his environment, he's the only queer LGBT person, you know, also. So once he lives there and he starts meeting other people, he creates this kind of like a network of affection. And I think that's really important for him to be able to move on, you know. I think both Pedro and Leo, they suffer some similar oppressions and some specific oppressions to each of them. But a big difference between the two of them is that Leo, he has this support of it from his friends, this network around him of affection, and Pedro doesn't. And once Pedro finds that, this is one of the keys, I think, for him to be able to move on, to step forward. It's about the music, it's what you do, so.
Actually, like from the very beginning of the process, even the writing, for me and Marcio, the music part's very important. We have the once we have an idea, we create like a playlist with songs that it can be related with the mood of the film. And then even during the rehearsals, like we still work in this playlist, and like
With the actors doing exercises on the
yeah.
music, so.
So, like, for example, I think 80% of the music of the film, there were we had them before shooting. The final song, for example, of Anoni, we shot the scene with the song, like, in speakers, with the whole extras and around Pedro. And for us, we always think how we can create this narrative mood also from music. About this film, we thought, okay, this is gonna be a very melancholic, depressive film, I think, but it also has this energy, this electricity that Pedro has, because he's always reacting to something. He's very like,
Fighting back.
yeah. So we've searched for mainly queer musicians, mainly Brazilian musicians also, that could relate somehow with this melancholic mood, but they should have something electric, something more like a dance floor. And then, like, we could find this musician, I think.
It's It's still hard to say because we don't know how things are going to develop, how they're going to unfold from the situation now. We hope it will be, but we fear that on these new directions that the government is taking might make harder and harder for films like that to be made.
Yeah, like today we could make a film like this, but little by little it's getting harder to access funding, especially to films like that. And with the whole society like putting the target in cultural segments and LGBT, of course, would be more arrest,
Difficult, yeah.
yeah, difficult to access some theaters. And but it's very hard because like it's the beginning of his government, you know, he's not like being a sympathizer of diversity or cultural investments, but he didn't. We have to wait a little bit and be ready to fight if we lose some rights, because we were ready to fight.
And this is what the film is about,
Yeah.
mostly, you know, like being ready to fight back. And I think this is something that we're probably gonna need in the next few years. So.
Yeah.